Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Today we are just going to start the new chapter, measurement. And the first topic is physical quantity. Now here, in our daily life, we just have to be use this term at every sort of the thing. So, what do you think about that? How we can define the term measurement? Here, measurement means the meaning of measurement is the comparison of unknown quantity. The meaning of measurement is the comparison of unknown quantity with a standard to see how many times it is big or small as compared to the standard. Now here, the word measurement is the comparison of the unknown quantity. Comparison of the unknown quantity means if we are just going to observe a table. So what will be the area of the table, or what will be the length of the table, or what will be the height of the table? Now here we just have to be their actual value. Either there will be the height, either there will be the length, either there will be the breadth. So let's suppose the actual length of the table is 4 feet. Now, so we can say this is the actual or standard length of the table. Now here, we are just taking an instrument to measure the length of the table. The depth is equal to 4 feet. So we can say, now we are just going to compare it. It is just going to match with the actual value or not. So if they are going to be matched, or if their length is bigger or smaller. So we can say we are measuring the object. We are measuring the object. We are measuring the physical quantity. In our daily life, we just having the different physical quantity. Either it can be mass, either it can be the time, either it can be the temperature, and so on. So if we are going to find out the mass of anything, so we just use the physical balance. So what is the mass of this object? So we are measuring the mass of the object. Now, in other way, we can say measurement is the assignment of a number. Measurement is the assignment of a number to a characteristic of an object or event, which can be compared with other objects or events. The scope and application of the measurement are depend on the context and discipline. Again, if we are just comparing the definition of the measurement, this one and this one, so both are the similar, but it means that measurement is the assignment of a number to a character. Mean we are just assigned a number of the object according to their characters, or we can say or event. Like if we are saying it is 10 o'clock or it is 11 o'clock, so we are measuring the time in hours, in minute, in second. So that is the assignment of the number with respect to the physical quantity. Now, which can be compared with other objects or even, like here also we just have to be comparing the two objects. You are comparing the object with their numerical value. The scope and application of measurement are depend on the context. Mean here, I was telling you that it is depend on the context. Depend on the context means that it depend on the physical quantity. Now, let's suppose if we are discussing about the speed, so their contexts are different. If we are discussing about the time, so their contexts are different. If we are discussing about the acceleration, so their contexts are different. So whenever the contexts are different, so a discipline or discipline will be the different. I mean, if we are telling you about the child, so their discipline will be said to be the second, the minute, the hours, and so on. Same as that. If we are taking the context as a length, so length will be in meter, will be in centimeter, will be in kilometer. It depends upon the situation. Again, I'm just going to repeat the definition of the measurement. The meaning of measurement is the comparison of unknown quantity. The meaning of measurement is the comparison of unknown quantity with a standard to see how many time it is bigger, big or small. Okay, now the next topic after measurement is physical quantity. You have seen that on listening me multiple times. I'm using the term physical quantity. You are thinking over it. What does physical quantity means? What does physical quantity mean? And what are the physical quantity? In our daily life, we are using different sort of the physical quantity. But according to physical point of view, we don't have to understand what does it mean and what they are. We are using in our daily life length, we are using area, we are using volume, we are using time, we are using temperature, we are using speed, we are using velocity, we are using distance, we are using displacement, and so on. Mean in the different sort of the physical quantity we are using. Now we are going to define the term physical quantity. Physical quantity is a property of a material. Physical quantity is a property of a material or system that can be quantified by measurement. Physical quantity is a property of a material or system that can be quantified by measurement. Physical quantity हमारे पास वो property है material की या system की जिसको हम quantified करते हैं by measurement. जब हम इसको when we are going to measure it, so we are quantified in either what will be its value, or in other way we can say a physical quantity can be expressed as the combination of a numerical value and a unit. When anyone is asking about the time, what time is it? So we are saying it is 10 o'clock. Mean 2 hours have been passed. Mean we just have to be used 10 minutes. We have to use 5 minutes. So two things are available here now. The first one is the numerical value. Numerical value can be expressed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. These are settled with the numerical value. And the unit which is expressing the physical quantity. Like we are using the term meter, we are using the term centimeter, we are using the term millimeter for length, we are using the term kilometer for the length. So all of that is showing the expression of the physical quantity. Same as that, if we are measuring the temperature, so their numerical value will be 45, 30, 25, 108, 110. So all of that are said to be the numerical value. But if we are using Kelvin, if we are using centigrade, if we are using Fahrenheit, so all of that are expressing by the unit to the physical quantity temperature. Now another example, we can say if we are just going to be generalize it, for example, the physical quantity mass can be quantified as n kg. I mean if anyone says you just have to be purchased 1 kg of tomato. So 1 kg of tomato representing the physical quantity mass. So 1 means that is a numerical value, and kg express the unit of the mass. Now, where n is the numerical value and kg is the unit. Again, I'm just going to define the term physical quantity. A physical quantity is a property of a material or system that can be quantified by measurement. A physical quantity can be expressed as the combination of a numerical value and a unit. As well as a physical quantity can be expressed as a combination of a numerical value and a unit. For example, the physical quantity mass can be quantified as n kg, where n is the numerical value and the kg is a unit. Now, physical quantity can be expressed in the two terminology. The first one is said to be the fundamental quantity, and the second one is said to be the drive quantity. When physical quantity can be differentiated in the two ways, the first one is said to be the fundamental quantity, and second one is said to be the drive. Fundamental means by which all of the physical quantity can be depend on it. Just like we study English, so first we have to learn about the alphabets. In English, we have 26 letters of English alphabet. When we are combining these English alphabet, then we get a word. And when we are going to combine a word, then we form a sentence. And when we combining the sentence, then we get the paragraph. The same as that, we can say a fundamental quantity, physical fundamental quantity and drive quantity. Now, those unit which is representing the fundamental quantity, then it is said to be the fundamental unit. And those physical point, those unit which is representing to the drive quantity is said to be the drive unit. Again, physical quantity can be expressed in two way or two type. The first one is the fundamental quantity and the second one is the drive quantity. Now, the unit expressed to the fundamental quantity is said to be the fundamental unit. The unit expressed to the drive quantity is said to be the drive unit. Now, second one, we are just going to define the term fundamental quantity. Fundamental quantity are independent, just like English alphabet. That is a fundamental. So we can say a fundamental quantity are independent and do not depend upon other quantities for measurement. Mean fundamental quantity are independent and do not depend upon other quantities. Mean these having the 7 fundamental physical quantity which do not depend on the other one. It is the independent, but the other will be depend on it. So the example of the fundamental quantity can be length, mass, time, current, temperature, etc. Units used to measure fundamental quantity are called fundamental units. Units used to measure fundamental quantity are called fundamental unit. Again, I'm just going to define. Fundamental quantity are independent. You just have to keep in your mind. Fundamental quantity are independent and do not depend upon other quantities for measurement. The example can be length, mass, time, current, temperature. And the unit which express to the fundamental quantity, we can say that is a fundamental unit. Now, These are the example of the fundamental quantity. Mean we just having the seven fundamental physical quantity. The first one is the time. The second one is the length. The third one is the mass. The fourth one is the amount of substance. Fifth one is the temperature. Sixth one is the electric current. And seventh one is the luminous intensity. Again, I'm going to repeat. These are the seven fundamental physical quantity. Now, the unit of the time is second. The unit of time is second, and its symbol is small s. The unit of time is second, and the symbol is s. S representing the symbol of second, while the time is representing with the small t. The quantity time representing with small t, while second representing with small s. Now the second one is length. Length is expressing with small l. Its unit is meter, and meter can be expressed by small m. Length can be expressed by small l. Its unit is meter, and meter can be expressed by the small m. Now, next one is mass. Mass is expressing with small m, while its unit is kilogram. Its symbol is kg. Now, amount of substance represented by mol. Amount of substance can be represented. Their unit is mole, and the symbol of mole is mol. And amount of substance is represented with a small n. Amount of substance is represented with a small n. A small n is representing with the amount of substance. Now, its unit is mole, and mole symbol is mol mole. Now, the next one is the temperature. The symbol of the temperature is capital T. Its unit is Kelvin, and the symbol of the Kelvin is capital K. Now, the next one is electric current. Electric current is represented by the I. Its unit is ampere, and the symbol of ampere is capital A. Now, the next one is the luminous intensity. Luminous intensity symbolically represented by the LV. Luminous intensity symbolically represented by the LV, capital L is small v. And its unit is candela, and its symbol is CD. Luminous intensity is represented by the capital L is small v. Its unit is candela, and candela is represented by the small d. Now, the next type of the physical quantity is said to be the drive quantity. Drive quantity, we can say the quantity which are derived from fundamental quantity or drive quantity. The quantity which are derived from fundamental quantities or drive quantities, or both fundamental and the drive quantity, then it is said to be the drive quantity. Again, I'm just going to repeat. Drive quantity can be extract. Drive quantity means can be extract, and drive quantity depend upon the fundamental quantity. Drive quantity depend upon the fundamental quantity, as well as it depend upon the drive quantity, as well as it depend upon the both fundamental and drive quantity. Their example can be, you can say, if we are talking about the force, if we are talking about the speed, if we are talking about the acceleration, if we are talking about the pressure, so all of these will come from the fundamental and drive physical quantity. All of that will come from the fundamental or drive physical quantity. Used to measure drive quantity are called drag unit. Mean those unit which expressing to the drive physical quantity, that is said to be the drive units. Now, these are the some example which I was told you orally. Now, speed. The formula for the speed is distance upon time. Distance belong to the length. Distance and length both are the similar, and time is the fundamental. Mean distance is the fundamental as well as time is the fundamental. When both are going to be combined together, then we got a new physical quantity, and that is the speed. So distance upon time is equal to speed. Distance upon time is equal to speed. So speed is a new physical quantity which depend upon the fundamental quantity. Now the unit of the speed is meter per second, and it is representing by m upon s. Also it can be written as m dot s minus 1. Now the next drive physical quantity are acceleration. Acceleration, we can say that is the rate of change of velocity. Rate of change of velocity. Velocity means that is the speed. Velocity means that is the speed. And t means that is the time. Velocity means that is the speed, and speed belong to the drive physical quantity. And second, or time belongs to the fundamental unit. So acceleration means the rate of change of velocity, that is said to be the acceleration. Mean here both will come, drive and fundamental physical quantity. Mean when the drive and fundamental quantity are combined together, then we are taking another physical quantity, that is said to be the acceleration. The unit of the acceleration is meter per second square. And it can be represented as m upon s square. M upon s square. Now, the next example are volume. Volume totally based on fundamental quantity. Because the formula for the volume, we can say that is the length multiplied by breadth multiplied by height. Length is also represented to length. Breadth is also represented to the length. And height is also represented to the length. So when we are multiplying length, breadth and height, then we got the volume. So the unit of the volume becomes the cubic meter, and it can be represented by the m3. Now the next one is the force. So force, we can say that is the product of the mass and acceleration. Mass belongs to the fundamental, while A depend upon the drive. So that is the combination of the fundamental and the drive physical quantity. So we got the force. Force is the product of mass and acceleration, and the unit of the force is said to be the Newton. The unit of force is said to be the Newton, and Newton can be expressed in the capital N, and according to the formula, V can also set to be M. M is the mass, and the unit of mass is kg, while the unit of acceleration is meter per second square. Here is now meter per second square. When kilogram meter per second is combined together, then it will form the Newton, and Newton can be expressed in the capital letter. Now the next one is the pressure. Pressure, we can say that is the ratio of the mass. Pressure can be represented by the force per unit area. Pressure is a combination of the force per unit area. Now here force is also said to be the physical quantity, while area is also said to be the physical quantity. So we can say that the pressure, basically that is a combination of the two drive physical quantity. Now its unit is Pascal, and Pascal can be represented by the PA, capital P, small a. Also, according to the formula, I was told you that force per unit area, the unit of force is Newton, while the unit of area is meter square. So the combination of the Newton per meter square, that can be represented by the PA Pascal. Now the next one is the work. Work, we can say force multiplied by distance, mean the product of work and distance is said to be the product of force and distance is said to be the work. The product of force and distance is said to be the work. While force is a physical quantity and distance representing to the length. So here work will come from the drive and fundamental quantity both. So the unit of the work is joule. Joule is represented by the J, and according to the formula, the unit of force is in Newton and the unit of distance is meter. So the combination of the Newton meter will become joule. After that, the last is charge. Charge, we can say current upon time. The ratio between current upon time, then it is said to be the charge. And the unit of charge is said to be the coulomb. And coulomb is represented by the C, and that comes from the ampere and second. Now, after that, when we are using unit to express, unit to express the fundamental or drive physical quantity, then it is set in the system. Or in other words, we can say a set of fundamental and drive unit is known as system of unit. A set of fundamental and drive unit is known as system of unit. In there are three system of unit. The first is amps, second is cgs, third one is fps. Now mks stand for meter, m for meter, k for kilogram, and s for second. While cgs, C stand for centimeter, G stand for gram, and S stand for second. While FPS, F stand for food, P stand for pound, and S stand for second. Now another name of the FPS is said to be the British Thermal Engineering System. In other way, FPS stand for, that is British Thermal Engineering System. Now, again, I'm just going to repeat. System of unit, a set of fundamental and drive unit is known as system of unit. There are three system of units being used in scientific world: MKS, CGS, FPS. FPS stands for food pound second, CGS stands for centimeter gram second, MKS stands for meter kilogram second. Now you just have to be note down your home task. Differentiate between the fundamental and drive units. Differentiate between fundamental and drive units. Write down SI unit of the following physical quantity: viscosity, stress, torque, temperature, momentum, and frequency.